look at Petco Park here on a fine Friday night. Tonight we begin our road trip with the first of three between the Phillies and the San Diego Padres. Hi again, folks. Welcome back to Phillies Baseball here on the show. I'm joined by Eric Harris and Steve Lyons as we delve into our pitching matchup here in the opener.
Well, let's take a look at the numbers right here. Each of these guys coming off of a loss in his last start, so they'll each be wanting to turn things around in this game.
Steve, EK will join us in a moment, but before he does, let's take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Philadelphia Phillies, as they'll align themselves like this here tonight. And look there at the starting pitcher charged with facing these guys, as his numbers are on your screen. The Padres alignment will look like this. Cesar Hernandez strides forward, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
Second baseman, number 16.
First pitch here is softly hit to the left side, and he's retired one away. Tyler Buriel is ready for his first AB here in this one. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder, but this is foul for the first strike. Bases are empty, one man out. The 0-1 is right back past him on the mound, and it's going to keep on going into center field. It's a base hit.
Boy, you talk about a ball having eyes. First off, he's fortunate to get this one by the pitcher. It's not hit especially hard, but you'll see it get past second base where neither middle infielder can track it down. And it'll make its way into center field.
Pause, now the pitch. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Now a swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit.
Yeah, the number two and three guys come through with back-to-back hits here with one out in the first. Now they've got something cooking, and they'll try to stake themselves to an early lead.
And that's in there, base hit. Now third base coach Juan Samuel's going to wave him in. And the run will score as the Phillies are off to a 1-0 lead.
Boy, what a great start to this series here in the first inning. On the road, you'd love to give your pitcher a little something to work with out there, and he's going to have a lead now before he even throws his first pitch.
And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. That's in there. Base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And a relay home. And he is in there at the plate. It's now a 2-0 game.
And I got a feeling the last thing these guys want to do is get someone up in the bullpen here in the first inning. And they might not have a choice because this is four hits against them already. And that last one was smoked.
Comes set. Now the pitch. Tommy Joseph is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. Eric, this Padre team as they take the field here tonight. It was another loss last time out, and this portion of the schedule has not done them any favors as they've dropped five of their last seven.
And it was the offense that went south last time out. Managed only just one run in the loss yesterday. It's typical when you're in a cold streak like this. They just had a lot of trouble sustaining any kind of offense, and it definitely hurt them.
And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. Freddie Galvis steps into the box, and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far. He waits. Now the pitch. Now a hard liner towards short. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So it's two runs on four base hits. No errors and a couple of men left on. Starting lineup for the host Padres looks like this. They'll face off against the American League's Rookie of the Year in 2011, the hard-throwing right-hander Jeremy Hellickson. Quickly, a look now at the defensive alignment they'll face in this one. Alexi Amarista comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Center fielder, Alexi Amarista.
And that misses for ball one. These Phillies, Eric Karros, as they enter play here tonight. They were losers last time out, but still in a decent groove as they'd won four of five prior to that.
And I think it's just going to be a matter of putting yesterday behind you. It wasn't their finest performance of the year, that's for sure, but they're capable of playing much better ball, and I think we'll see a sharper focus here in this one.
And as we take a look at the numbers from his last start right there, he's going to need to be a little bit better. Five runs allowed in that previous outing. A couple of huge hits really did him in, and he's going to have to stay away from the big inning if he wants to change his fortunes in this one.
High strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. One out, nobody on. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Yeah, he came with a little bit of a different look that time. This pitch is also in their knee-high, and now they've got him behind in the count, 0-2.
And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. And this will be chopped foul here at home plate. Just gets a piece of it. Still 0-2. And boy, what a battle brewing here as he fouls yet another pitch into the seats. Still stuck on 0-2. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
And these long at-bats give you a good sense of what a guy's featuring here in the first inning.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Will Myers gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame. Now here it comes. Curveball just misses, apparently. 1-0. That missed close. It's ball two.
And this is what you got to do up there, Steve. You got to wait him out.
Yeah, and if you can lay off the off-speed stuff, that's when you're going to get your fastball to hit.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. They walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner. Brett Wallace, set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will get foul for strike two. He's ready. Now the pitch. Fouled straight back. Another 0-2 coming. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. And that is through into center field, a base hit.
A good job there making a two-strike adjustment. Very compact there. He uses the middle of the field. And this just finds its way into center for a base hit.
Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Padres leave a pair. They're still... Cameron Rupp makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
Cameron Rupp.
And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Jeremy Hellickson settles into the box for his first chance. Now the pitch. Swing and a ball headed towards the hole. And a base hit into left field, so they've got themselves a one-out base runner. Cesar Hernandez will get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game. He's set. Now the pitch. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Come set. Now the pitch. Now a ball hit hard towards the hole. And that is into right field, a base hit.
Boy, the hits just keep on coming here. You see the highlighted column right there. That's six against him already, and we're just in the second inning.
Line hard into left. Jay is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out.
And that's one of those plays where you might need to reinforce the laces on your glove after this inning ends. This is a fastball, and it is hammered. I mean smoked. But he ends up with nothing, and his average is going to go down.
That's hard. And, oh, this is off the second base bag. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away. Michael Franco will dig in here with the bases loaded now and a chance to really do some damage.
He's been tough to deal with this year. He's second on the team in RBI, so this is a golden opportunity.
From the belt, the pitch, and a foul tip held onto here at strike one.
Yeah, you know, when a pitcher gets into a little bit of a jam out there, you can bet he's going with his best stuff. So we may see a heavy dose of that slider right now.
And he goes down and gets this one as it's lifted high into the air out to medium deep center. Amarista is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands. Derek Norris strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning.
Catcher, Derek.
In there, and it's 0-1.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you got to do it. You can't give up on that inside corner, or this guy will bury you.
And this is chopped foul at the plate. He's in the hole now, down 0-2. swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out. John Jay digs in, ready for his first plate appearance.
Sean Jay.
The pitch. And that's by him. It's 0-1.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. And the off-balance throw will be too late, so a good effort that time, but it's an infield single. Alexi Ramirez steps in, hoping to get things going at the plate. You can see it's been a bit of a struggle for him in recent games. Runner goes for second. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. It's offline, but he's out. Gunned down trying to swipe the base. Now here's the pitch. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. And this is hit well towards the hole. Oh, and it sailed right over his head at first.
Well, everything looked okay here on the pickup and transfer, but then you see him just fire this thing straight into the box seats down there. That's going to be scored an E5 and a lucky souvenir baseball for one of the fans.
Number 61 swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is... Cody Ashe is into the box as we are all set to begin the third. And this is fouled at the plate. Popped up towards the seats as this gets out of play. Here's the pitch. Swing and a high pop-up back onto the outfield grass now. One away here to begin the third.
First baseman number 19, Tommy Joseph.
Tommy Joseph comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time. And the pitch. Oh, missed that one by a mile. It's 0-1.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now. Hit high and deep out to left field. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A solo shot here to left. Home run number 15 for him thus far. And the Phillies open up a 3-0 lead.
Boy, the ball is definitely jumping here early. That's the first home run we've seen so far, but it's not the first hard hit ball, and it's looking like it might not be such a good night to be a pitcher.
The batter, number 13,
stepping in now, Freddy Galvis. As he'll swing and lift a foul ball off to the left and out of play. Swing, hard hit ball to second. Throw on to Wallace will be in time, and there's out number two.
Now batting, catcher, Cameron
Rupp stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And he'll avoid the fragments out there to make the catch that ends the inning. But the Phils tack on one more on this solo home run. We've played 2.5. It's now 3-0 Philadelphia. Alexi Amarista will try it again. He flied out to start the home first.
Alexi Amarista.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And reined in, one away.
Now batting, third baseman.
Yonhervis Solarte is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Now the pitch. Now a changeup here to start things out, but that'll dip a bit too low, and it's 1-0. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now. 3-0 now. You have to figure that he's really going to need to keep the walks in check if he's going to have success here.
I was thinking the same thing. No free rides. You've got to make these guys earn it.
Now a ground ball towards the hole. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Up next for the Padres.
Will Myers will stand in. He drew a base on balls his first time. 92 splits the plate, and it's strike one.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer in that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
Ashy is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Jeremy Hellickson is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
Catcher, Jeremy Hellickson.
Here it comes. Softly hit and a little floater out towards second. And this will be put away easily for the out.
Well, always nice to have the pitcher leading off an inning, and here he retires him to start the fourth.
And he'll go after the second pitch of the inning as this is on the ground over to first. And Wallace will just handle this one himself for the out. Tyler Buriel will stand in. He singled and later scored back in the first. And a good slider here to start the at-bat, but it's ruled a ball, 1-0.
Jeez, finally. That's the first ball they've taken all night. About time, boys.
Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. From deep in the hole. And the throw will not be in time, as I don't think he was going to get him anyway, but a fine effort nonetheless. Odubel Herrera digs in, coming off a single in his last at-bat. Now he spins on one here and drives it to deep right field. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. Sixth home run on the season for him. And the Fightin' Phils have opened up a 5-0 lead.
Got to be out there on the mound saying, what on earth just happened? He was cruising along. He got the first two outs, then on two pitches, single, home run. I tell you, you can't let your guard down 1 second out there. You're going to get burned.
In now, Michael Franco. As he's first pitch swinging here, and this is on the ground toward the hole. Throw in time, and the side is retired. But the Fightin' strike for a pair, both coming on this two-run home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Phillies 5 and the Padres nothing. Brett Wallace is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
First baseman, Brett Wallace.
Thank you. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Good curveball. Strike two. In front of the changeup there as this is chopped foul at home plate. And this is swung on and missed as Wallace becomes out number one. Ryan Shipp in now, popped out in his first trip.
Ryan Shipp.
And a fastball's in there for strike one. No runs, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Padres. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
And they may have found a location that they like right here. Two different pitches, both taken on the inside corner, and now they can go just about anywhere they want.
Joseph backs up and takes care of it. Two away.
The catcher, number three, Derek.
And you can see what they're trying to do on show track. In, in, and in. Now he finally gets him to pop something up here.
Into the box, Derek Norris. Oh, and this one has hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder. And he's not going to get there. It's over his head. And he'll make it in there with a two-out double.
Yeah, I think this was a changeup that just hung a little bit too much in the strike zone. Let's take another look at it here. Normally, you want this thing to sort of run out of steam and dip on its way out of the zone. But he starts this one up a little bit too high. And to be honest, he's pretty lucky that this one stayed in the ballpark.
John Jay is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. From the stretch. And he misses with it 1-1.
You've got options here, so you don't need to go after this guy if you don't want to.
Swing and a liner. Foul. One-two pitch is a curveball that misses 2-2.
Yeah, and on 1-2, when you know the guy at the plate needs to protect, that's a great spot for that curveball. A lot of guys, I would have gone fishing for that.
Now a curveball in there. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. Paul Clemens is going to take over here in inning number five as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep them in the game here. Cody Ashe will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. Swing and a liner. And that's through, a base hit.
These guys have been aggressive here early in the count. Some people think, oh, you might want to take a pitch to start in that bat. And sometimes that's great, and it works out for a lot of people. But what you should be thinking is, I got to swing at strikes, and I got to get my pitch. And if it happens to come on the first pitch, let it rip.
Looks like double-barreled action now in the San Diego bullpen as they get a lefty and a right-hander up to throw. One and one. The early hit total, about what you'd expect in a score line such as this. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. As a look, now the pitch. And he gets around on the fastball here as this is hit well out toward left field. And that's in there. Base hit. The relay. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Freddie Galvis
will stand in another dangerous spot here in the inning as this ball game is hanging on the precipice of getting out of hand.
Yeah, I think you have to get this guy if you're going to have any chance of sticking around. Even a single here might put this one out of reach.
Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But a foul ball here, 0-1. And this is hit sharply on the ground toward the hole. Dive, but it's off his glove, and that ought to get at least one run in.
Now batting.
Cameron Rupp will get his third shot at it here. He's bounced out and popped out in his previous two trips. From the belt, kicks and deals. Fouled straight back. Pause, now the pitch. Slow curveball, like a balloon, and he couldn't hold back. It's strike two.
Now with two strikes, he can put the ground ball on the back burner and really go after the strikeout here.
And quick wrists here as this is yanked down the third base line. There's one on the first, and they get the double play. But boy, was he ever upended at second base.
Well, this is a potential rally killer right here. They do get one run, but it costs them two outs in the process.
Standing in now, Jeremy Hellickson. Now a ball lifted high in the air towards shallow right center field. Chip will put this one away, and the side is retired. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and no one left. Home. Alexi Ramirez will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings. Wow, just a jam sandwich right there. And all he's holding is about half of his bat. Those look like the kind of bats I used to swing with.
Now here's the pitch. Now a broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. Alex Dickerson will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number one, Alex Dickerson.
First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
You can hit the low fastball, but you're not going to hit that one up there. You can just forget about it. You've got to make him bring that thing down.
Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. I had him lunging there as he's just able to tap it foul at home plate. And that is going to sneak on through into right. It's a one-out single.
And on the mound, here's where you got to keep pitching like it's a one-run game. You never want to get in that relaxed mode where you think, eh, I've got some cushion. I can afford to give up some hits. That'll spell disaster.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. No runs, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Now a swing and a ground ball, but this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. Swing and a miss at the curveball, and there's your second out of the inning. Yonhervis Solarte will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Sets the target low here, and it misses one and one.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about. You don't want to give this guy something where he can just roll over a ground ball and still get it in the right field.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Padres leave one. They need to get... Brad Hand will come on now to try and sort this mess out, as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here. Cesar Hernandez will stand in to lead things off here in the Philadelphia sixth.
Second baseman, Cesar Hernandez.
In the air to right center. There to take it is Myers, and that's the first out.
The right fielder, number two,
Tyler Gurriel, ready for another at bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far. Now here it comes. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Oh, and here's a fastball right down the middle of the plate that swung on and hit out to deep left field, and this one's not coming back. This is a long home run. A solo shot here to left, sixth home run on the season for him, as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
This is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Odubel Herrera will stand in again as we flash you back here to the fourth inning. This was a two-run home run that was definitely one of the big blows of the ball game to this point. Late swing and a ball line fouled into the seats past the third base dugout. Out in front as this is pulled foul into the seats. Bases are empty, one man out. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away. Michael Franco strides in, grounded out his last time through. Now here's the pitch. First pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air to straightaway center. Amarista is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Phillies get one in the frame courtesy of this solo home run. Bottom of the sixth coming up. It's the Phillies 8 and the Padres nothing. Will Myers will step in to get the Friars going here in their half of inning number 6.
Will Myers.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Fastball that time is nowhere close, and it's even at 1-1. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. And a bouncing ball, foul. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
What a difference 5 days can make. He's been a totally different pitcher out there compared to his last start. The command is much better. The pitches are much sharper. Even the body language tells me he's got things under control.
Brett Wallace comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. And now a pitch on the way. Grounded fouled off to the right side. And the pitch. Oh, and he takes this one to the opposite field. High and deep to left center.
Pereira
is there to take it, and that's the second out of the inning.
Boy, his guys got him the lead back in the very first inning, and he hasn't looked back since. He's had everything go his way so far, and this inning's turning out to be no exception.
Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line. And no one will track it down. Now the pitch. I just couldn't pull that one back in time. It's 0-2 now. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Cody Ashe is set to get us started for the late innings of this one.
The left fielder number 25, Cody Ashe.
Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. Jay is there to put this one away, and it takes just one pitch to record the first out of the seventh. Tommy Joseph will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Now the pitch. Fouled back. He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Amarista comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number 2.
And this is all about taking charge out there. That's the center fielder's ball if he can get there. So he calls everybody off and he makes the play easily.
Now here's a slow grounder to the left side. Barehanded at his knees. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired.
It's time.
Derek Norris steps into the box as the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the seventh. The pitch. Here's Hellickson back to work now as he jumps ahead of the first man to greet him here. It's strike one. In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
Boy, I'll tell you, to be down 0-2 against a guy like this with the stuff he's got tonight, not a comfortable spot to be in.
Throw on to first in time, one away.
The left fielder number 24.
John Jay steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Starts things here with a changeup for a called strike. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Yeah, ground ball out to start the seventh. Now an 0-2 count. He's looking sharp as ever.
And he'll try to hold back, but he won't be able to, as that's ruled a swing, and there are two away now.
Well, there's a look at his pitches by inning, and as you can see, he's hit 85 for the game now, so you have to think they're watching him pretty closely in that dugout.
Alexi Ramirez will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. Breaking balls in there that time, 1-1.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
And he looks at one in there, 1-2. Now a swing and a sharp ground ball toward the hole. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now, so he may be getting just a little bit tired.
And here's a fastball called for strike one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
It doesn't take a trained eye to tell you. He's starting to wear down a bit out there on the mound.
Swinging a ground ball to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One left for San Diego. Carlos Villanueva will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Cameron Ruff will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Swing and a miss on the slider, nothing and one. This is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. And this is on the ground toward the hole. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Jeremy Hellickson steps in for a fourth plate appearance tonight, and why not? He's been in control all game. Now a swing and another ground ball. This one out to short. Throw on to Wallace will be in time, and there's out number 2.
Second baseman.
Cesar Hernandez will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now here's the pitch. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Now here's a fastball up that he sends in the air out to fairly deep center field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Philly. Alexi Amarista will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
You know, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Carlos Ruiz is going to come in now and take over following the injury.
Now catching, number 51, Carlos Ruiz.
Here's the pitch. Hit high but foul as that'll get in amongst the fans. And here's a ball hit in the air. And that'll get down for a base hit. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two base hit.
Well, you got to start a streak somewhere, and he's well into this one now. A 6-game hit streak with that base hit. He's swinging the bat pretty good right now.
Changeup called strike one. Well, we'll give you a look there at the graphic. That's now 14 doubles on the season so far. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at one. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. A at second, nobody out. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Time to be alert for signs of tiring here in the eighth. He's a pitch away from 100. And a full count now, 3-2. Swung on and taken the opposite way out toward deep left center. Under it is Ashy, and he'll put it away for the first down. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away.
That's a heads-up play there at second base. He sees that left fielder has to move all the way into the alley to catch this thing, so he knows he'll have a hard time readjusting his body to make the throw to third, and he's able to move up 90 feet on the flyout.
Here's the Philadelphia manager on his way out to the mound now. And that's going to do it now for the starter, Jeremy Hellickson. So he was able to only get that first out in the eighth, but nonetheless, he'll depart with the lead. Hector Neris will come in now working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here. He's ready now, the pitch. And this will find the seats behind the first base dugout. One out and a runner on third. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
And on 0-2, I'd be shocked to see another fastball in the strike zone.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Brett Wallace will stand in. He flew out his last time up. He's set. Now the pitch. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. That man's team has definitely shot itself in the foot with all the strikeouts so far.
It seems like it's been a growing trend so far, but...
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger.
Your attention,
Matt Thornton will now come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth. Here we go with inning number nine as the first pitch misses for ball one.
And think about it, in game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend.
Swing and a line drive to left. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
And this is what folks mean when they talk about time in the fastball. He looks at the first pitch just to get a feel for the speed, the movement. And then when it comes again, now he knows how to handle it.
He's ready. Now the pitch. Ground ball to second. This could be two. Ramirez for one. And he'll have to hold on to it there as the takeout slide had him well off balance.
Well, this is a pretty smart decision here at second base. He's got that clock running in his head, so he knows he's about to take a shot. So at that point, why risk throwing this ball into the dugout or into the 10th row? He just absorbs the hit, and he hangs on to the baseball.
Into the box now, Michael Franco. Swinging a ball pretty well hit out towards left center. Amarista calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out.
The left fielder,
Cody Ashy will stand in. He flew out his last time up. From the belt, the pitch. Here's a ball skied in the air near the line, back behind first. Schiff is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Ryan Schiff will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one. swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two.
Oh, you like the way this guy is just going about his business here. He's got a big lead, but he's pitching like it's a tie game here in the ninth.
A little bit off the outside, it's one and two. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
The catcher,
Derek Norris will step in. A ground out victim his last time. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Credit where credit's due. This guy's done a good job out of the bullpen.
No question. He's been able to hold that lead, and these guys really haven't threatened him at all.
And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now. John Jay stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here, with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And they start him out with a slider. Good spot, but he doesn't get the call. 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one. The swing, and he pulls it down the line and deep. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And with that, I can finally say the four words I've had on my mind for what seems like an eternity. This ball game is over.
And I think just about everybody wound up having a hand in this victory as they go on to win this one by 8 runs.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he definitely turned in the standout performance in this one. He finishes with an even 10 strikeouts, and he was instrumental in leading his guys to the victory.
So that's a wrap here tonight. Eric Karros, Steve Lyons, Matt Vaskirjian, you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Facebook at MLB The Show. The Phillies win this one 8-0. Good night from San Diego.